were you able to conduct a comparison from that item?
Yes.
And were you able to draw any conclusions?
Yes.
And what were they?
Paul Stevens Jr. is identified as the source of the STR DNA profile obtained from item 4-1-1. So for this sample, there was only DNA from one person that we were able to obtain. Again, this is from the blade of the knife. And when compared to the reference samples, Paul Stevens Jr. is identified as the source of that profile.
And again, what just briefly, what does it mean to be identified as the source of the profile in the blade of the knife?
Basically, the statistical analysis gave us a number that is more rare than 1 in 7 trillion. And, you know, for reference, 7 trillion is if you had 1,000 Earths, each with a population of about 7 billion, you would expect to see the profile come up one time in 1,000 Earths, each with a population of 7 billion. So it's more rare than that. We are calling that person the source of it, and in this case, from the blade of the knife swabbing, Mr. Stevens is the source.
Now turning to the handle swab, which was 4-2-1. Did you complete your testing on that swab?
Yes.
And what were your conclusions, if any?
The STR DNA profile from item 4-2-1 is not of sufficient quantity and or quality for comparison purposes.
Now looking back to S35 briefly, the report that you created in this case, is that something that was created in the normal course of your business?
Yes.
And do you do it, is it something that you would create with regard to any case that you are the forensic scientist on?
Yes.
At this time, Your Honor, the state would ask to admit S35 into evidence.
Mr. Masciocchi.
No objection.
State has no further questions, Your Honor.
All right. Mr. Masciocchi, you can move across. Ladies and gentlemen, I recognize the time. We're going to finish this witness. I'll give you a little extra time for lunch today. I appreciate your patience. Mr. Masciocchi, you may proceed.
Thank you, Ron. Sorry, I'm just in the box. You're hidden behind me.
Sorry. Board.
That's fine. That's fine. With regard to the specimen collected from the right shoe, which is, we've identified as 3-1-1.
Yes.
Right. There is, it's clearly some of the DNA retrieved from that shoe belongs to Mr. Stevens, based on the report.
Yes.
Mr. Teeter can be ruled out.
As the, so for the major contributor, Mr. Stevens matches that profile with that 1 in 2.62 trillion. And Mr. Teeter is excluded from the major contributor.
So there are potential other, an unknown sample from an unknown source.
There is additional DNA on that item, which is the shoe sample. But it isn't suitable for comparison to anyone.
Okay. And then getting back to shoelace 3-3-1-1-1, that contains, that's positive for Mr. Teeter's DNA, is that correct?
Yes. He is identified as the source of the major DNA profile from that item.
In reviewing the various samples of blood from which you determined. Well, you got the sample, the blood's already tested by a previous analysis analyst and then given to you for DNA comparison, correct?
Yes, I received a portion of the stain that was identified during the serology test.
So in the samples that you reviewed, you can't tell how old the samples are or where in terms of one versus the other?
That's correct. There's no way to tell when DNA was placed on an item.
I have another question. Thank you.
Thank you.
State.
time. I'm going to give you your instructions. I'll give you report time. As you know, you're not to discuss the case with anyone until the trial is over, you're charged by the court of the law, and instructed to begin deliberations. Then you may only discuss the case with each other, and only when the 12 of you are in the jury deliberation room. Do not listen to any or read any television, newspaper, or other account of the trial or case, or conduct any personal research or investigation. You cannot communicate about this case on your cell phone or through any other means. You are only to consider the evidence seen or heard in the courtroom and mainly discuss the evidence during deliberations. And please refrain from consuming any alcoholic beverages during your lunch break. Do I have your collective assurances?
Yes.
Phillies won a close one last night, 15 innings.